Today for seniors going beyond the cruises, bus tours, or fishing trips, why not try volunteerism to shake things up? That's a trip that combines the love of travel with volunteer work, and Savvy Senior Editor Jim Miller is back. Thanks for being here.
You bet.
Well, this is a lot of fun because you've told us in the past, people sometimes delay retirement because they still feel the need to be useful.
Yeah.
But now you can retire and still be useful in a meaningful way, plus travel.
Yeah. It's a great way to be able to experience the country more like a local versus a tourist. But there are lots of different organizations that offer these, Heather, that will range anywhere between like 1 and 3 weeks, and they're also available abroad and in the U.S., so you can have lots of different options out there.
Okay, and some of them have some pretty specific themes. What are the most popular themes?
Typically, most people, the volunteer jobs that they do on these trips are they either teach English, they work with kids or teens, they rebuild homes or schools, or they assist in environmental projects or community projects. So they have a variety of different options that they can pick from.
Could someone go by themselves, or do they need to go with a spouse or a companion?
You can, anything. You can do solo travel, couples, groups, and it's a wonderful way for solo travelers to be able to go take a trip and experience something. It gives them a reason to go, and they can also connect with other people as well. Also, too, you don't need a foreign language. A lot of people ask about that. Do you need to be able to speak the language of the country you go to? You don't have to do that. Probably 99% of the people that go on these trips aren't speaking the language to be able to do that. And the cost is another thing. People ask a lot about the cost. That'll range anywhere between like $1,000 and $3,000, depending on how long the trip is. Typically, it's about $1,000 per week. And most of the trips are either 2 or 3 weeks.
Okay, so if you're going to volunteer, could this be tax deductible, say if it's for charity work?
Yeah, most of the organizations are nonprofit, so they are. The trip is tax deductible along with the airfare, so you can get your vacation tax-free. You know, it's a great way to write off on your taxes.
Yeah. I need to find out what volunteering I can do in Bora Bora. That'd be nice. So where do you go? Where are the best places to go to find out about these opportunities?
Okay, so I have a list of really hot places here. The first one is Global Volunteers. It tackles hunger and poverty and educational needs in 17 countries, including the U.S. Earthwatch Institute emphasizes environmental conservation and research in countries all over the world. Cross-Cultural Solutions, I actually did a trip on Cross-Cultural Solutions, focuses on health, education, and economic volunteer opportunities. Biosphere Expeditions offers wildlife conservation expeditions in 13 countries. Habitat for Humanity, a lot of people are familiar with that, offers international housing building trips in more than 40 countries. And the Sierra Club does dozens of service trips in the U.S. throughout their local chapters. So these are some of the great places that are very reliable that you can really trust, that you can tap into to find these programs.
Before people go ahead and take the leap, what are some things they should consider?
You know, I think you want to ask yourself, you know, what country you want to go to and what types of work you want to do. That kind of limits it down. You also want to consider, do you want to work alone? Do you want to work out in the country? You want to ask yourself about the ability to be able to handle it from a health standpoint, especially for older boomers mm-hmm. and seniors.
Yes.
Because a lot of these trips are very physical. And so, you know, the travel, especially if you're traveling abroad, you've got to think about that. And then also the accommodations. These are not five-star hotels you're staying in with these trips. Most of them you're going to be staying with a host family, or you might be staying in a bunkhouse, something like that, with other volunteers. So it's not necessarily comfortable, but it's a wonderful way to be able to experience the country like a local versus a typical tourist. So it's pretty neat.
That is amazing. My dad travels sometimes to Malawi, but he usually comes back with malaria or something crazy, so I know exactly what you mean.
Yeah.
Thank you for being here. We always appreciate you.
You betcha.
For more information on searching for a volunteer vacation, we have all of this on our website. Plus, you can also check out Jim's website, SavvySenior.org.